गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू आर फाइन। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू पोएम एंड नेम ऑफ दैट पोएम इज द काइट। वी आर गोइंग टू डू रिविजन ऑफ दिस पोएम बिकॉज इन मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल यू हैव लर्न दिस पोएम। So, without wasting time, let's start the poem. Let's see who is the poet of this poem. Yes, name of the poet is Harry Benn. He born in September 24, 1898, United States, and he died September 6, 1973, United States. This poet is known as a screenwriter and children's author, means he has written many stories and poems for children especially. So you can see this poem as a poem for children, and his notable work is The Big Parade, La Bohème, Hills Angels, The Farewellers. So these are some his poems. Now children, see the picture. What you see in this picture? Yes, two beautiful kites are flying in the sky. Do you like to play with kites? Have you ever played kites? Yes. And now tell me, when you would like to play kites, in which season and in which month we play? Because in our India there is one festival which is very famous, and when that festival comes we play kites in the sky. Correct. In time of Makar Sankranti, in month of January, when the sky is clear, we like to play kite. So you must play a kite sometime because it's very beautiful thing to do. When you will see a kite is flying up in the sky, you will also feel that you are also flying with the kite in the sky. And these feelings and emotions are expressed by the poet through this poem, because poetry is a powerful expression of thoughts. So imagine that you are flying a kite, and that kite is flying in the sky, and what is happening up there and how the world is looking from that sky. So let's see some information about the poem. So what the poet exactly want to tell through this poem? So he has drawn a beautiful picture of the flying kite through words in the poem. Means after reading this poem, we imagine that how the kite is flying in the sky. We are on ground and we are flying the kite in the sky. We can't go up there, but we can imagine how the kite is flying in the sky. And we all love to see flying kites, but we never notice how it flies, how it moves through wind. So through this beautiful word picture of a flying kite, the poet is just persuading us to fly one and notice its beautiful moves. Means poet is telling through this poem to go out on the ground and fly the kite, play with the kite and enjoy that, and see the beautiful movements, See how that kite is moving because of strong wind. When the wind blows strong, the kite goes up high and moves here and there. When there is no wind, the kite is not able to fly up in the sky. So, wind plays very important role in flying kite. Now, let's see summary of the poem. In the clear sky, means what exactly poet wants to tell here? That there are no clouds. Means after rainy season, when winter season comes, there is clear sky. We see no clouds in the sky. So we can play kite very well at that season. So a kite will look bright in it. We generally used to play kites which are very colorful, with different and bright colorful kites comes in the market to sell. And when we buy that and when we fly kite in the sky, because of the clear sky and blue color sky, that kite looks very bright and it is clearly noticeable to us. We can see it clearly. The kite hurls and with every wag its tail produces a cracking sound. You all know how the shape of the kite, that see here the shape of the kite and tail of the kite is also shown here. So its tail is moving and making sound when the wind blows, and with the movement of that kite, tail moves here and there and makes sound with a cracking sound, means it makes a cracking sound. Then while flying, all of a sudden the kite goes high on the top, just like a ship goes up and down on the crest of waves with a sailcloth. Means what? Here, when the strong wind blows, what happens? Suddenly that kite goes more up in the sky. And that kite is compared to a ship who moves from ground to hilltop. And it moves forward when the wind is strong. Again, it moves up forward when the strong wind blows. But as the wind falls means when the wind is very low, it seems as if it is also taking a rest for a while in the air. Means that kite didn't go up, but it only flows very slowly. Fly very slowly, and it seems as if it is also taking a rest for a while. Means like kite is taking a rest for a while in the air. Sometimes the thread tied to the kite loosen. Means we used to move the thread of that kite star, and thread tied to the kite loosen. The flyer tries to roll and the thread and runs till a new breeze fills its wings. Means what exactly poet wants to tell here? That kite is tied to the roll with help of a thread. A big thread is there. A big thread roll is there in our friend's hand or in our brother's hand, and we keep that kite's thread in our hand, and when we lose that thread, that kite goes up and moves here and there, and with help of wind or breeze we move the kite very well. And what it looks like? Like that breeze or air is filling its wings, and It's running here and there with help of that. So it's a wonderful imagination created by the poet. And a kite really looks bright on a clear sky. But when it gets struck on a treetop, it gets torn and gives a poor look. Means sometimes what happens while playing the kite goes on the treetop. It's struck there. And when we try to pull out the kite from that tree, it gets torn and gives a poor look. We don't like to see that kite again. Then we again have to take out new kite and play, because we can't pull that kite down because the tree is very high. On the top of the tree, we can't reach there. And the kite's paper is very delicate, so we can't use that kite again to play. So this is the imagination of the poet. And through this poem, poet wants to tell us that how kite flies in the sky and what happens to that kite when it comes down on earth and stuck on a treetop. Now here some words are given with meaning. Means you have to underline the words while reading the poem, or you can note down these words while I'm reading. So you can note down the words with meanings also while I'm reading the words. Now on your screen you can see these words with meanings are given. So you can write as fast as you can, or you can underline these words in your textbook or in your notebook. You can write only words and you can search the meaning of it in the dictionary later. So I will read these words for you. So first word is given here, blue. Blue means a color, but here what it is indicating, that here is blue means the sky. See the color of the sky, it is blue. So it is only mentioned the color blue, not blue sky. So here blue means sky only. So dive. Dive means what? Dive means to descend through air. Means here this dive is not in the swimming pool or not in the river, but through the air it is coming down towards earth, because the air is very low. Next is deep. Means here to lower and raise. Means here that kite is coming down and going forward, up and down, because of air, strong air. Next word is snaps. Means to make a sharp sound. See here the kite's tail, which is making sharp sounds through wind is blowing, because wind is blowing very strong. Next is soars. Means to fly upwards. When wind is strong, the kite goes upwards. Tides. Generally, tides are found in sea. But here, what it is indicating? Rise and fall in the air of kite. So as the air is strong, the kite goes up, or when the air is low, kite comes down like a tide. Next is crest, the highest part of the sky we can say, or any hill or mountain. Next word is slack, to get loose. means sometimes we have to loosen the thread while playing the kite. Next word is breeze. Breeze means light wind. Here dactyl means rough and worn. Rough and worn. Flaps means to move up and down. Means when that kite stuck on the treetop, it gets very rough and worn and we can't move it up and down, and when we try to move up and down, it gets torn. Now let's read the poem loudly. You also read the poem with me. You can see on the screen. So, the kite. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. With a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail. Then soars like a ship with only a sail. As over tides of wind it rides, climbs to the crest of a guest and pulls. Then seems to rest and wind falls. When strings go slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blows. And its wings fill and up it goes. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. But a ragged thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. Poem is written by Harry Bain. So we have read the poem. Now we will see the poem in detail. The kite. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new. With a dive and a dip, it snaps its tail. Here, some words are given with meaning again. Dive and a dip means to go into water with a force and softness together. Means it dive and dip of kite in the sky is compared to the sea dive here or water dive. When the swimmer dives in the water, how it feels and how it goes, that is compared to the kite here. Next is snaps, means a cracking sound of a tail, of kite's tail here. Blue means it is a color, but here it is used for the clear sky without clouds. So when a kite looks bright on a clear sky when it flies for the first time. Means when we buy a new kite, it looks very bright on a clear sky where clouds are not there. Then it moves with softness and force together at the same time to fly. Makes its tail to create a cracking sound in the air. Means when the air blows very strong, it moves with force. And when the air is low, it moves very softly and very slowly in the sky. And this movement makes a cracking sound of a tail of the kite. Next lines are, then soars like a ship with only a sail, as over tides of wind it rides, climbs to the crest of a gust and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. Means here, soars means fly high, climbs means to go up. Sail means a cloth on a ship or a boat used to catch wind and help the boat to
propel. Tides means rising and falling waves. Crest means mountain top or a tuft of feathers on the head of a bird or animal. Means some words are taken here from another or related to another thing, like sailing is related to the boat, tides are related to the sea, crest is related to the mountain top, or feathers on the head of a bird or animal. But it is compared here to the poem or to the kite in the poem. So such moves help it to float in the sky. Like as the kite moves here and there, it helps to float the kite in the sky, and just waves rising and falling with the sudden blow of the winds. Means when the strong wind blows, it rises up in the sky, or it falls down with a low wind. And when strong wind blows, it goes up to the highest point in the sky in a wavy manner. Means its tail is moving continuously and making sound, and the way a ship moves on the ocean. But as soon as the wind slows down, it seems as if it has stopped there to rest. Means when any ship sails in the sea and on the tides or on the waves of the water, it goes up and down and moves. And like that, this kite is moving in the sky, up and down, rising and falling like a ship in the ocean. So here kite is compared to a ship of the sea. Now we will read next lines. When strings go slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blows and its wings fill and up it goes. Here slack means loose. When we lose the string of the kite, or when the thread tied to the kite loosens, the flyer runs and roll it back. Means two people need to fly the kite. One which is holding the roll of the thread, and one person who is holding the thread of the kite and who is loosening the thread. And with the help of that kite roll and the person who is holding that kite roll, that we used to run here and there and loosen the thread. And this way the kite goes up in the sky or comes down and moves here and there. So imagine that you are flying a kite, and when strong wind blows, you loosen the thread and you start to send the kite up in the sky with help of wind. And for that you have to roll the thread roll, and you have to loose the thread again and again and pull back down or move it upwards. So that he waits till a new breeze, means we have to wait till new breeze blows again. If there is low wind is blowing, we have to wait for the new breeze blows again and fills its wings with air again to help it fly high. Means how bright on the blue, means what here again, when the low wind blows, we have to wait for the new breeze, strong breeze, to blow the wings of the kite again to blow or to fly high. So it depends on the wind. So when clear sky is there, when wind is blowing high, we like to enjoy to play kite. And I must say that you also try this game when you will try to play the kite, you will able to enjoy this poem more. Now, next stanza. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new, but a ragged thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. Now, what happened? That wind blows very strong and sometimes it's low and kite is moving up in the sky. But when, again, poet is saying that kite is looking very beautiful and bright in the clear sky. But when it gets struck on the tree top, it gets torn and gives a poor wound. Means it worn out look which is not liked by anyone. Means you feel sad na when your kite struck on a treetop or struck on a strings of wires and that kite gets torn. So you won't like to look at that or you can't get that back down as a new one. So this way we have seen a poem of the kite, in which we have seen how the kite goes up in the sky and moves here and there with help of wind, and it looks like a plane or a ship of the ocean. How when the movements of the sea tides, that with help of that movement, that kite ship is sailing in the ocean. Like that only with help of wind here, kite is moving here and there in the clear blue bright sky. Now, here are some questions given. So, you can note down these questions or you can do one thing. You have PDF copies of your textbook. So, take the PDF of this list poem and you can write down the question answers. If you have already written in the month of April, then very good. Or you can write down today also. So, what are the question answers given? So, first question, I will read it for you. List out the action words in the poem and find out the meanings of these words. Like some action words are given, dive, dip, snaps, and remaining words are climbs, blows, soars, rides, falls. What is mean by action words? Means something action is happening in that moment. So climb means what here? To go up. It is not climbing up staircase or not climbing a tree, but it is going up in the sky. Blows means to hit. When the strong wind hits that kite, it goes up. Next word is soars. Soars means to fly. It helps to fly the kite. Next is rides. Rides means here to sit on the back of something and control its movement. To mount means when we fly the kite with help of string or thread. What we exactly doing? We are riding that kite and we are controlling its movements. Next word is falls. Falls means to drop down. So learn these words with meanings and you will get the proper meaning of the poem with help of these words if you will understand these words. That's why I'm reading question answers also for you. Next is read these lines from the poem. What are these lines? Two lines only given here. Then soars like a ship with only a sail. Means the movement of tailless kite is compared here to a ship with a sail. This is called simile. Can you suggest what or who the following actions may be compared to? So here some sentences are given. Like here, the kite is compared to a ship which is sailing in the sky with help of the cloth, and the kite's tail is compared to the sail, to that cloth of the ship. So here it is a simile. Simile means what? It is a similarity given between these two objects. And some sentences are given here. He runs like means you have to give the similar sentence or similar object of the which is indicating here his running. So he runs like. So you have to write the answer. We will discuss answer also, but try to think on it that your friend runs like a what? So you have to put that correct word in the blank space. He eats like what? You have to compare that and write it. She sings like. So you have to find the correct word here which indicate that girl singing. It shines like. What thing is very bright and shineful or shining? You can use it here. Then it flies like. So it flies like a, it might be a flight or aeroplane or anything you can write here. So let's see answer also. So he runs like the wind. So wind is compared here with that boy who is running very fast, very fast and with a force. Now next answer is he eats like a pig. Means not exactly he is compared to the pig, but like an animal who likes to eat more or in a large quantity. You can write any other animal or any other person name also which is exactly gives the meaning of that same word. So next answer is she sings like a nightingale. Means here that girl is compared to the nightingale, a bird. Next is it shines like a star. Stars shine in the sky at night. So that object is compared or here similar to that star. Next is it flies like a bird. So that object is flying or aeroplane is flying like a bird in the sky. You can see here the simile is given between two objects or two person or two things here given. So have you enjoyed reading the poem and understanding the concept? I hope you understood this poem very well, and I explained question answers also for you, so you will get the correct meaning of that. And when these type of questions will come in the exam also, you will try to write the answers very well. Now I have given two activities for you. You have to do that after this session gets over. So what is the first activity given? Write summary of the poem in your own words. Means what you understood from this poem and what exactly the poet wants to convey through this poem, you have to write in your own words. So use your own imagination, thinking, and then write. Now next activity is you have to draw a picture of a kite after this session. Means you have to draw a picture of a kite. Means you have to show a clear sky, blue sky, then you have to show kite which is flying in the sky exactly like shown in the poem or in the first picture of this poem as I have shown you. So I hope you enjoyed this poem very well and you will able to understand the meaning of the poem and write in your own words. So after this session we are going to start a new lesson. So up to this we have seen revision of, first we have seen revision of who did Patrick's homework. In second session we have did revision of the poem A House, A Home. And now this is the second poem or third session of revision, which was based on the poem The Kite. Now, in the next session, we are going to learn a new lesson, and we will see that lesson in next session. So you can read Unit 2 lesson. And what is the name of the lesson? Yes, How the Dog Found His New Master. We will see that in next session. How the dog found himself a new master. We will see that lesson in new session. So, thank you very much.